In this video, I will show you how to extract structured data from unstructured data using large language models and Flowise. Working with unstructured data is one of the most common use cases that I've experienced as an AI engineer, and it's definitely a skill that you want to add to your AI toolkit. So, what do I mean by working with unstructured data? First, let's have a look at a super simple example and then ramp up the complexity. In this text file, we have some information about two characters. This contains their name, their age, where they live, and their occupation. This is considered unstructured data. Let's assume that you wanted to extract some information from this file, like the person's name and age, so that you could work with that data within some custom application or an automation workflow, or maybe you simply want to extract this information and store it in a database table. This would be very difficult to achieve, if not impossible, using traditional coding. But now we can use the intelligence of large language models to extract any information we need from any type of unstructured data. Or let's have a look at a more complex example, like this invoice, where we might want to extract certain information, like the invoice date, the invoice number, the individual line items, the totals, etc. So in this video, you will learn how to use output parsers and large language models to extract any data that you want from simple examples like this to advanced structures like invoices. And for this, we will be using Flowise, which is a free open source AI application builder. If you wanted to learn how to set up Flowise, then check out my getting started video over here. So in this application, we can upload a file from our machine, and Flowise supports all sorts of file extensions, or we can simply enter the data within this chat session. John is 40 years old, lives in New York, and is a software developer. And what we get back is a JSON structure containing the name, age, city, and occupation. And in this video, you will learn how to define the exact structure that you want to get back. And you will also notice that age is actually a number, whereas the rest of these fields are strings. So you can also define the type of value that you expect to get back. Let's also try uploading a file, like this file that I showed earlier. This file contains two subjects, James and Mary, with their information. So I'll select that file from my machine, and within the chat, we can now specify which subject we want to extract information for. Like, the subject is James, and of course, we get the correct information back. Or let's try changing the subject to Mary. And now we're getting Mary's information back. And this is working as well. And take note that this JSON structure is consistent. In other words, the property names and the type of the values are consistent between each of these responses, giving us a reliable way to work with this data from within or outside of Flowise. Or let's try a more advanced example, like this invoice that contains all sorts of information about the invoice, individual line items, and just to keep things interesting, the total is actually on a separate page, and this type of printing issues can easily happen in the real world. So within our chat, let's select that invoice, and for this one, we actually don't have to provide any instructions, so I'll just enter go. And you will now see that this structure is way more complex than the previous example, where we have the invoice number, the date, invoice totals, the currency symbol, and the items as an array of values. So hopefully you're starting to see the value of learning how to work with unstructured data. So typically you wouldn't run the extraction within Flowise like this. This is simply for testing sake. But Flowise does expose API endpoints that you can call to pass in the contents of the file, and then you will receive that JSON output structure as the response. Now let's go ahead and build this. Within Flowise, go to chat flows, and then click on add new. Let's save our chat flow. Let's give it a name, like unstructured demo. Then let's start by adding an LLM chain. Go to add nodes, then under chains, let's add the LLM chain. Chains allow us to attach output parsers, and it's the output parser that will take the response from the LLM and convert it to JSON. But let's first start by adding our large language model. Let's go to add nodes, then let's go to chat models. And at this point, you can definitely add chat o llama to run some local models like the llama 3.2 3 billion parameter model, which we've used in previous videos. But for more advanced structures, like with the invoice, I do recommend using one of the more advanced models. So I'm actually going to use one of the Anthropic models. So I'll add chat Anthropic. Let's attach the LLM to the chain. Then under credentials, if this is your first time using Anthropic, simply click on create new, give it a name like Anthropic API, and then for the API key, go to anthropic.com/API, then click on start building, create your account, and you should receive some free credits to get started. Then click on get API keys, then click on create key, select your workspace, give it a name. I'll just call mine unstructured demo, copy the key and add it to Flowise. Click on add and select your credential from the dropdown. Then for the model name, let's select Claude 3.5 Sonnet and let's lower the temperature to something like 0.2. This will ensure that the model will closely follow our instructions. Now let's add a prompt template. Let's go to add nodes, let's go to prompts, and let's add the prompt template. Let's also attach this node to our chain. We can use the prompt template to provide instructions to our AI model. So let's open up the template and let's enter the following. From the provided context and additional information from the user, return a JSON structure. So what I want to do here is provide context from a file as an example, and we also want to allow the user to provide information as well. For instance, to tell the LLM who the subject is. Let's provide placeholders for those values. So I'll start with the user context, and we can create a variable by adding opening and closing curly braces with the variable name. Below that, let's also add the file context with a variable called context, like so. So question will represent the text from the chat window, and file context will include the content of the file that we uploaded. Let's save this. Let's go to format prompt values, and now let's assign the values for these two variables. For question, we will select the question from the chat box, and for context, we want to select the file attachment. We can now close this pop-up. And finally, we now want to provide an output parser. We will have a look at two different output parsers in this video. Let's go to output parsers, and here you will find a CSV output parser, a custom list, the structured output parser, which is what we will use now, and we will also have a look at the advanced structured output parser as well. And this will allow us to add things like arrays and nested structures. But let's start with the structured output parser. Let's attach this to our chain, and let's define the structure that we want to get back from this application. Let's go to additional parameters, and here we get two examples, which we can delete. Now, looking at this data, I want to get back the name, the age, the city, and the occupation of any given subject. So let's add those values. First, let's add a property called name, and for the type, we can select string, number, or boolean. The name will be a string value. The description is really important, as this will tell the LLM how to extract the information for this property. So let's enter the name of the subject. Let's add another item for the age, which is of type number, and with a description of the age of the subject, let's add another item for the location. This is of type string, and for the description, I'll enter the city or town of the subject. And let's add one more for the occupation, which is of type string. And for the description, let's enter the occupation of the subject. This should be it for this example. Let's close this pop-up and let's test this. Let's save this flow. Then in the chat, I'm going to expand this. We can now enter anything that we want. So in the chat, let's simply enter something like John is 30 years old, lives in New York, and is a software developer. Let's send this, and this seems to be working. So how can we add file uploads to this chat? That's quite simple. Let's go to settings, let's go to configuration, let's go to file upload, and let's enable full file uploads. And save this. Now, when we go back to the chat, we are able to select files from our machines. So I've selected the sample file, which contains two subjects, James and Mary. So let's say the subject is James, and we do get the information back related to James. Now let's try the subject is Mary, and of course we have to upload the file again, As these chats do not have conversational memory, we're not building a chatbot here after all. So let's try this again. The subject is Mary, and we do get Mary's information back. So it's very useful to upload a single file and to then tell the model which subject we want to extract information for. The amount of use cases for this is pretty much unlimited. Now let's move on to a more advanced example. Here we have an invoice containing all sorts of information, like the invoice date, the invoice number, a due date, the items, subtotals, and the overall total. Now, the structured output parser is ideal if you are dealing with a flat structure. But what if we wanted to have nested objects or arrays, like the individual invoice items? For that, we can use the advanced structured output node. I'm actually going to remove the structured output parser. Let's go to add nodes, and let's add the advanced structured output parser. Let's attach this to our LLM chain, and let's set up the structure. Let's click on expand. This might look intimidating, but I will show you a super simple way of creating this structure. You can use something like ChatGPT or Claude to generate the structure for you. Simply enter something like create a ZOD schema with the following values. Then you can provide the name of the property as well as the type. So it could be a number, a string, an object, a boolean, etc. As well as the description of that property. This is following the exact same structure as we saw with the structured output parser. Then Claude or ChatGPT will generate some sort of response that looks something like this. What we're interested in is everything from this z.object all the way down to the closing brackets, like so. So we can simply copy this and then add it to Flowise. So here we have the invoice number, which is of type number, and more specifically an integer, so there are no decimal places, and this can only be a positive value. And of course, we have to add a description to tell the LLM how to identify this information within the unstructured data. So we can do the same thing for the date, the invoice total, and the currency string. We will add an array in a minute to extract the invoice items. But let's keep things simple for now. Let's save this, let's save the chat flow, and let's test this out in the chat. So I'll clear the chat as we are working with new data. Then I'll select the invoice from my machine. We don't have to provide any user context in this case, so I'll just enter go, and we can see that the invoice number is indeed 9996 with a due date of 25 November 2024. This is correct, and we can see that the total is indeed £500 and a currency symbol of British pounds. Now let's see how we can take this to the next level by also including the individual invoice items as an array of values. And I simply recommend using Claude or ChatGPT to do this as well. So I'll simply paste in the value, which is called items, which is of type array. And within the array, we can specify the object or the structure of each of these array items. And all we want is a description of the item along with the item's amount. Let's save this change. Let's save the chat flow. I'll select the invoice and let's enter go. And we are getting an error message, but I do want to show you this instead of editing it out. We are getting a message saying that we could not parse the date because the property expected a format of date, but instead we received the format of string. So working with dates can be quite tricky, and there are ways around it. But to keep things simple, I'm simply going to change the date to a string instead. But what we can do is tell the LLM in which format we want to receive this date. So let's enter something like as day slash month month slash year. Let's save this change. Let's save the chat flow and let's try this again. And look at that. We received the invoice date in the correct format and we also get this array of items coming back. If you enjoyed this video, then please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel to support my work, and check out these other Flowise videos over here. I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.